Stand by for action. We are about to launch Stingray. Anything can happen in the next half hour.
Father, you've left your file behind.
File? What file?
Why, this one. Isn't it yours?
Never seen it before. It's not mine.
Father, it's a manuscript. Look, there's something written inside the cover. To Atlanta, my dearest friend, from Marina.
What is it? Some sort of novel she's been writing?
Listen to this. I feel I owe it to you and all my friends at Marineville to tell you at long last a little about myself. It will probably come as a great shock to you to know that I am able to speak.
Marina? Able to speak? But she hasn't uttered one single word since she's been with us.
Listen, Father. Although I have not uttered one single word since I arrived in Marineville, the fact remains that I am able to speak. My silence has been forced on me by a very evil curse placed on my people by the cruel Titan. In order to understand my dilemma, I must tell you my story from the very beginning.
I don't get it.
Well, let me read on, Father. Story begins at a time when the underwater races of the world were as yet undiscovered. It was a very happy and peaceful existence. I lived with my father, Afany, Emperor of Pacifica. The city of Pacifica, as its name implies, was built on the bed of the Pacific Ocean. Legend has it that our community started centuries ago when the captain of a sailing ship fell in love and married a beautiful mermaid, giving us dual characteristics of the land and the sea. The royal palace was a splendid affair. It was built entirely from seashells of every shape, color, and variety. The vast rooms were a kaleidoscope of color. Numerous fountains, driven by the pressure of the sea, provided an exotic playground for tropical fish. Vast panoramic windows enabled the occupants of the palace to observe the wonders of the deep. But perhaps the thing I most remember is the stillness, the tranquility that prevailed beneath the mighty ocean. My father was a peace-loving man who worked tirelessly to bring about unity and harmony of the undersea races. Of course, this was before the power of speech was taken away from us. One day, I received word that my father wanted to see me.
You wish to see me, Father?
Yes, my child. I have a special task for you. I want you to prepare the most lavish banquet that Pacifica has ever known. There will be 400 guests, and no detail must be spared. This could be the most important evening in the whole of our existence. I don't want anything to go wrong. I am relying on you, Marina, to do your best. Now, are there any questions?
Just one, Father. Who is the guest of honor?
Titan.
Titan? But he is our arch enemy.
Indeed. It is a great victory for the peace-loving people of Pacifica that he has accepted our invitation to attend our conference. It is my hope that after this great meeting, peace will be secured for our people for all time.
But, Father, can you trust him?
It is a calculated risk we must take. Without his pledge, our conference will mean nothing. Now, about the menu. We'll have the vintage seaweed wine, the octopus soup, followed by roast electric eels.
The preparations went underway, and on the night, the banqueting hall looked magnificent. Soon, underwater vessels of every shape and size were arriving from all parts of the undersea world. Delegates from every community were present, and soon the banquet was underway. The splendor of the costumes added to the already dazzling spectacle. The atmosphere was genial, and as my father's speech drew to a close, it seemed that success was assured.
And so, my friends, I am pleased to report that at the peace conference this morning, every undersea community within 10,000 marine miles of Pacifica have signed the peace treaty. Only one signature remains to be obtained. It is that of Titan, the mighty leader of the great and powerful city of Titanica. I now call on him to address you and to make known his decision.
The atmosphere was electric as Titan stood up to speak. Would this notorious warlike leader sign the treaty or not? That was the question everyone was asking.
Sea maidens, seamen, and aquafibians, as it is well known, the Titanican people have always regarded themselves superior to other races. The master race of the sea. And indeed, nothing has happened to alter that belief. However, because we believe that our natural superiority will eventually be recognized by all the other underwater races, I have decided that the name of Titan shall be added to the noble document that has been drawn up earlier today.
The atmosphere was one of great gaiety, and the seaweed wine flowed freely. Everyone was busy celebrating this great occasion. So much so that no one noticed Titan quietly slip away. How he must have smiled to himself. And as the party continued, the Titanican armada of Terrafish was approaching Pacifica. Titan, now safely installed in his flagfish, barked out his instructions.
This is Titan calling all aquafibian crews. Surround Pacifica and stand by to attack.
I was congratulating Father on his achievement, and the party was at its height. This is indeed a great night for you, Father.
Indeed it is, my child. Better than I dared hope. Peace has always been my mission, and at last it has been achieved.
Pacifica,
The mighty ocean was cascading into the palace. Huge pillars and statues were crashing to the ground. People were screaming. Casualties were heavy. Unlike your people, Atlanta, our people were not in danger of drowning. And among some of the survivors were Father and myself. Despite the terrible blow, my father refused to be defeated. He continued his peace mission. For months, we lived like hunted animals in a cave, until the Titan terrorfish finally left the area, believing that the Afni rule had been completely wiped out. But soon, the survivors of our community had banded together, and a new Pacifica was rising from the ocean bed. My father traveled secretly to other communities, spreading the word of peace. His speeches once again brought unity among our peoples and gave them fresh hope and courage. One evening, I was alone in my room, gazing out of the window into the hazy beauty of the ocean, when suddenly, from behind a rock, loomed a Titan terrorfish. I ran to my father to warn him. Father! Father! I've seen a Titan terrorfish. I think we're going to be attacked.
Calm down, my child. Yes, First Minister, what is it?
Great Sea Leader, Afony. The evil Titan is here and requests an audience. He is in the anteroom.
Be careful, Father. It could be a trap.
Bring him in.
But, Father...
Hush, my child. Do not be afraid. Go, First Minister. Bring him to my presence.
Something is going to happen, Father. Something terrible, I know.
He is coming. Do not show your fear.
Oh, mighty Emperor Afony, the warlord Titan.
Mighty Emperor! I thought I had settled that question once and for all.
Please state your business, Titan.
Very well. I'll be brief. I have been hearing of the grand speeches you've been making, Afony. And I understand you have had a certain degree of success. Not that they stand much chance against my mighty power.
Do not underestimate the power of words.
Indeed, I do not. But I do not intend to let them continue. You have made your last speech.
What is happening?
Father, Father, I'm afraid. I feel so strange.
Silence!
Titan! What does this mean?
Silence, I say. Silence!
Father!
Don't bother with him. He is dead.
What have you done?
This is not my doing, but yours. From now on, every time you or your daughter utter a word, one of the citizens of Pacifica will surely die. You are doomed to a lifetime of silence. This is my revenge on you, and my spell cannot be broken. And remember, Afony, one word could mean the death of your precious and lovely daughter, Marina, or of yourself, if she should speak.
Of course, we can never really know whether the death of our First Minister was a coincidence brought about by shock, or was the curse of Titan. But we have never dared gamble the lives of those we love to find out the truth. The thought that one spoken word from me could bring about my father's death is more than I can bear. So you can see why I am a prisoner in my silent world. So long as Titan lives, I am his slave. The luxury of words denied me. One day, perhaps I will be free of him, and can tell you how much your friendship means to me.
Well, I guess we know now what's been the matter with Marina. She's been reliving this terrible experience. Must have been pretty rough for her.
Yeah. And I didn't make it any better, did I, tonight? I wish there was something we could do to help.
I guess all we can do right now is make life as happy for her as we know how. It'll only be a matter of time before we get Titan. History has proved that his type always come to a sticky end. Affany and Marina will win through. You'll see.
Say that you'll always stay close to my